your most optimistic you, dreaming for the world of tomorrow, for your children and mine and the youths who are going out into the world? Can you give voice to that dream? What do you wish for?
Well, you know, for me, what I wish for, well, you know, I'll mention the work that I'll mention Steros, which is the world's first soft skills academy. And, you know, I'm chief growth officer of this organization. And, you know, we have a grand vision, which is, you know, teaching soft skills, life skills, workplace competencies, power skills, whatever, essential skills, whatever you want to call them, or opening the possibility for the younger generation to connect with these things, right? Sure. That would be a dream. Wouldn't it be great if the education systems, right, in Ireland and the UK, we'll just take those for example, just got over themselves a bit, right, and started saying, well, maybe we should incorporate some of this into our curriculums. Maybe there is something in this. Maybe it's more worthwhile bringing some of this. Maybe we should just park religious education for 1 week and replace it with power skills or whatever you want to call it, essential skills. So I guess a dream would be that the authorities, and we're talking about education here, wake up and realize that, you know, businesses are going to suffer if we don't embed all this into our education system. Children will suffer because they're not going to really optimize their growth processes and they're not going to match their capabilities with their hope. We're all going to suffer. So that would be a huge dream. So seriously, the education system wakes up.
Yeah, and a re-engineering to render our education systems fit for purpose.
Much more fit for purpose. And, I think partnership as well then between educators, administrators, HR professionals, straddling HR tech, getting the smartest HR technology brains and educational technology brains to use education for good, right? To match all this sort of stuff. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I'm a positive person. I think that will happen. My concern is, I hope all this other mushy stuff we've mentioned doesn't happen quicker, right?
Yes, so it needs to happen now. Time is
happen now.
Yeah, time is of the essence, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
It really is. And maybe for all its downsides, COVID has shone a light on an awful lot of deficits.
Yeah.
So it can be that time for growth on a very, very root level, fundamental level, right through to with each individual, harnessing their own innovation through this time. My father had a great one: necessity is the mother of invention, and he was never stuck for a plan. And I think we need to instill that in our young, will resurrect it in ourselves as well.
Absolutely. And, you know, and soft skills are critically lacking, right, in all of this. And you know, and children have become, you know, so insular because of the digital ages and avatars and video games and limited social interaction. And as I said before, you know, 7 hours a day, average social media consumption, and that lack of in-person interaction impedes children's ability or young people's ability to learn through trial and error, to visualize body language. Body language is so important. 93% of communication is body language. If our younger generations are not picking up body language, what the hell? How are they going to communicate? And then how are they then going to gain coping skills and build up their knowledge base and their awareness base? Mm-hmm. And then you have all the shielding factors that come from parents and educators. We need to get out of that stuff. We need to break out of that stuff.